All. I am Asfareen Ashad and you are watching my wonderful channel Times with Zan and Asfareen. So today we are going to learn about movements of the earth from class 5 social science. So let's start. Movement of the earth. Rotation and revolution are the two movements of the earth. We do not feel the movements of the earth because everything on earth, including air, moves along with it. Rotation of earth. The earth rotates, spins like a top about an imaginary line. This imaginary line is called axis. Earth's axis. Earth's axis runs through north and south poles. The axis is not straight, but is tilted at an angle of 23/1/2 degrees. The spinning. The movement of Earth on its tilted axis is called rotation of Earth. When Earth completes one rotation on its axis, we say it as one day. It means Earth takes one day, 24 hours to complete one rotation on its axis. Earth rotates from west to east on its axis. Because of this, sun appears to rise from the east. Day and night. Days and nights are caused due to the rotation of the earth. As the earth rotates, the half of the earth that gets sunlight will have day and the other half that is away from the sun will have night. Revolution of earth. The movement of earth around the sun in a fixed path is called revolution of earth. The fixed path along which Earth revolves around the sun is called its orbit. Earth revolves in an anti-clockwise direction from west to east. Earth takes 365 and 1/4, that is 6 hours, to complete one revolution around the sun. When Earth completes one revolution, we say it as 1 year. Where does the 1/4 of a day go? For our easy calculation, we take 365 days as 1 year and we keep 1/4, that is 6 hours of the day aside. Once in every 4 years, we add up the 4 1/4s and have one full extra day. Leap year. The extra day is added in February as it is the shortest month, and thus February has 29 days once in every 4 years. The year that has 366 days is called a leap year. Seasons. We experience different seasons on Earth. Revolution of Earth causes changes in seasons. The half of the Earth that is tilted towards the sun gets maximum sunlight, and the places in this region experiences summer season. Summer season. When the northern hemisphere is tilted towards sun, the places in northern hemisphere experiences summer season. Summer solstice. On June 21st, the North Pole tilts the maximum towards the sun. The places in this hemisphere have the longest day and shortest night of the year. This day is called summer solstice. Now let's learn about winter solstice. Winter solstice. On December 21st, the North Pole has maximum tilt away from the sun. The places in the hemisphere have the shortest day and the longest night of the year. This day is called winter solstice. Equinox. Equinox is the day when the day and night are almost of equal duration length all over the earth. Please check out our other videos, subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for more updates. Bye. See you in our next video. Thanks for watching.